incredible honor to be part of this exhibition, and really great to work with the staff here. It's been a great experience. And I wanted to talk about the piece that I have here, which is titled Inverted Listening of Explosive Enemy Aircraft Sounds, which is a project that I wanted to realize for a long time, and C-Lab and this theme of this exhibition was the perfect setting for it, so I'm very happy to be able to work on this. This work is based on a record that was released in 1943 in Japan during World War II, called the Explosive Aircraft Sound, and Explosive Enemy Aircraft Sounds.
首先要感谢 C-Lab 还有尤薇这次邀请我参与这次展览，那这次先和各位各位介绍作品呢的作品名称叫做颠倒聆听笛音爆音集。这个作品其实我的心中有这样的想法已经很久了一段时间了，很高兴这次在这个主题之下，我觉得非常适合把这个作品呈现给大家。这个作品呢主要来源呢是各位看到在画面上这个1943年在日本所发行的唱片，名称叫做笛音笛机爆音集。
This record was released commercially. And it was a four-disc set with sounds containing sounds of enemy aircraft sounds, so engine sounds, with the purpose to train Japanese people how to distinguish which planes they are.
这张唱片当时在日本是商业发行，总共一套有四张唱片。那其中呢，就录制收录了很多敌人的飞行机或者这些战机他们的引擎的声音。当时这张唱片的目的是希望能够训练日本的民众去熟悉那个敌机的声音是什么样子。So
there's no music on the disc. There's only these engine sounds, and then there's a voice narration explaining what are the characteristics of these airplanes and what to listen to be able to understand which planes they are.
唱片里面并没有任何音乐，那里面有的只有引擎的声音，还有一个男生的声音在描述说这每一种不同的战机它们声音上面的特质，希望大家在聆听的时候可以去注意到这些特质之后，进而辨别出不同的机种。My
first task was to try to get my hands on this record, which often is displayed in museums. And if I look online, they sell for about $1,000 to $2,000.
我当时的第一件事当然是希望能够取得这套唱片。一般的唱片的时候都是在博物馆里面展示。如果你要在网上面搜寻购买的话，一套大概都要价值$1,000到$2,000。But
as I asked around record collectors, it's actually not a very rare record amongst the collector circles because it's such an oddity. It doesn't have music. It's sort of a novelty record. So this man named Sato-san at Fuji Record said, let me go check. And he found one copy out of the four copies and said, I'll give this to you for $10.
后来我就开始去询问收藏家有没有这套唱片，然后发现其实，在收藏家之间，这套唱片并不罕见，因为毕竟这套唱片本身就非常的特别或不一样，没有任何音乐，它只有引擎的声音，所以我就询问各位在画面上看到这张富士这张照片里面富士唱片里面的佐藤先生，问他有没有这套唱片，他说他当时有四套，那就后来就愿意用十美元的价格转让给我一套。Of
course, I told C-Lab that it cost me $3,000, so I put that in the budget, and that's what I received from C-Lab. But I'm joking, you don't have to translate. Well, I was able to get two more copies in the cover, and that's part of the exhibition this time.
So, 当然后来就跟C-Lab开玩笑说，我这套唱片可是花了$3,000买到的，到时候要报在账里面，当然这是开玩笑的，所以我并没有用这样的方式报价。后来我得到这张唱片之后呢，各位在展场里面就可以看到这张唱片的其中两张，还有它的封面。
However, this record is very well known and very discussed among different circles, but just by listening to the record, you don't understand the context of this and the history of this record. So I went out on this exercise of trying to invert the listening of this record, try to listen to what's not heard in this record to understand the context of how this record was released.
这张唱片虽然在部分的收藏家还有玩家的心目之中呢，其实非常的普遍常在讨论，但对一般人而言，光是听这张唱片的时候，并不常会不明就里，不知道到底用途是什么，目的是什么。所以我是第一件事情，就希望能够翻转这张唱片，然后做翻模之后呢，试图去听听看这张唱片里面我们原本听不到的事物。And
this process is represented through these three records I made with a local record maker. Chu Minxing, who's also named Mr. Roy, who made positive records. So records, he made imprints of the records and made a mold and made an inverted version of these records for me. And these are displayed in the exhibition right now.
那各位看到在画面上这三张呢，这是我跟当地在台湾本地的收藏家邱明金先生合作的产物。那邱明金先生呢就会把这三张这唱片翻模之后，再翻成各位画面看到上面看到这三张，也目前出现在展场上面。
And as I do research, the context of this record, and this is documented in many academic papers and many memoirs and statements, two aspects emerge as an important context of how this record was made.
在研究这张唱片的时候，我翻阅了很多的学术期刊里面，发现他们其中不论是在学术期刊里面或者是在回忆录里面，都会提到其中两项的面向。
One is the science of sound and the weaponization of hearing. So during the wartime,There was a research in scientific and educational fields of how to use sound as a practical method of in the battlefield and in war.
其中包括了声响的科学，还有把聆听这件事情拿来当作武器。在战争期间的时候，其实很多的，不论是在科学界或者教育界，都会去分析说声响如何在战场上面成为一种武器或者工具。
So these were developing devices of how to listen to far away of aircrafts coming closer or being able to understand the weapons that the enemy is using through just listening.
比如说各位看到画面上面他们就透过不同工具之后试图去聆听或者是追踪或者去辨识到远即将要逼近的这些战机的声音或者是透过声响的方式去判断敌人用的是什么样的武器。
And another way of implementing this was through music education. So there was there was a lot of music educators who were pushing for music education based on pitch recognition and tone training.
另外一方面，在音乐教育的话，就有很多音乐家当时在努力的推广跟推动，希望训练大家透过去聆听，不论是音高、音准、音调的方式，去辨别敌机的样貌。
So in order to push this method of music training,They kind of convinced, they lobbied the military saying that if you train your ear with perfect pitch, if you could distinguish between notes in a piano or in any kind of sound, you could use that same ability to detect warplanes or enemy weapons.
当时这些人就是透过游说的方式说服军方说，如果透过这些绝对音感跟绝对音准的训练之后呢，让大家都熟悉了这些音准跟音感之后，你就可以在战场上面去运用这样的特质跟这样的能力，进而去辨别敌方的军事武器。
So the way they trained the children was to not only play instruments but play records like this and would have three notes, and children would listen to this over and over again.And try to guess what are the three notes. And often they'll use color cards or they'll write it down on a score sheet.
所以当时的话，除了用乐器的演奏，还有一种用播放唱片的方式，其中就有三个不同的音符跟音高，然后让儿童去反复聆听这三个不同的音高之后呢，让他们能够透过比如说用色卡的方式或者用写下来的方式去辨别到底这些音高何在。
And this was eventually implemented in the national educational system in 1942, pushed by prominent educators and scientists and academics.
后来在这些教育家还有科学家的推动之下，在1942年的时候，日本也把这样的教育训练放置进入到了国民教育体系当中。
The other important context of this record is as the war progressed, the concepts of war started to shift.And the two concepts that shift was mobilization and boku protection of the airspace.
当时在战事在发展的过程当中的时候，其实大家对于战事里面的想象跟运作也开始有些改变。其中两项改变呢，一方面是动员，一般民众的动员；另外一方面是防空，要去保护日本的领空。
So as the war became more progressed, and Japan was in much difficult situation, war wasn't fought only by soldiers.But now citizens, especially young students, people with disabilities, were expected to participate in the war effort either through labor or by working in watchtowers.
比如说在这个过程当中日本的军方面到越来越多的困境跟险阻的时候，他们开始动员，就不再只有军人动员，开始全民动员。在动员的情况之下，除了学生要参与之外，很多的残疾人士也同样需要参与，不管是透过劳动的方式，或者是到了这些监控塔、监听塔去监视敌军动态。
Also, the idea of protecting the airspace wasn't something a responsibility of the military anymore, but became a citizen's responsibility that every citizen had to watch out. They had to participate in detecting enemy warplanes, but also protecting themselves. So these characters of boku, which are flipped, is not to protect the airspace, but to you have your own responsibility of protecting yourself from attacks from the sky.
那防空这个概念也同样开始转变，那防空不再只是军方的目的跟责任了，一般民众也必须要去防空。那防空的目的呢，一方面要保护这个整个领土的国土，另外一方面也要保护自己，所以这个防空开始也强调保护自己的用途。
So my piece exhibited has several sound elements that I created, and one is that there's an academic paper that was released in 1944, which included notations of students listening to the record that I showed earlier and trying to write down the notes of the airplane sounds on a score.
这次展出的作品当中，那其中一部分呢是各位看到这些文献跟文件，文件里面左侧的话是1944年，当时在这个学术论文里面的时候，他们就记录了很多学生在聆听了这些唱片的音高音准之后，把它们记录在谱上。So
I had these notes played by a saxophone player to sort of simulate the sounds of the airplane sounds, and this is played in the room.
那我们拿到这个手稿之后呢，就请右侧刚才这位萨克斯风的乐手，请他来依据这个谱记手记谱之后呢，把它演奏出来。各位在展场里面就会听到这样的片段。The
other sound in the room is a recording that I made at these listening trenches, these watchtowers that are located in different areas in Japan.
另外，各位在展场上面会听到的片段呢，则是我在这些防空的监视哨或听音考里面所录制的片段。
So the expectation was that these students who train their ears will go to these listening holes. These are literally kind of holes dug on the mountaintop. They would sit there for days or hours and try to listen to if airplanes come. And if they detect it, they're supposed to make a phone call to the headquarters to let them know before the airplane reaches the central part of Tokyo.
那当时军方的期望是，这些学生经过训练之后呢，他们就会派遣到这些日本各地的这些听音好，或者是在山顶上面监视哨的时候，他们就坐在这个地方好几小时或好几天的声音。如果他们侦测到任何的声响的话，他们就随时打电话或打电报的方式回去给总部，让他们知道敌机即将来临。And
the other part is a modified turntable, which uses a bamboo stylus, which during the war there was a lack of metal. So they had to use bamboo needles, and these were also made, represents the labor that a lot of children and also people with disability had to do in order to contribute to the war.
各位看到，那在展场上面还有另外一个，就是这个经过调整后的唱盘。那在这个唱盘当中，这个留声机的上面的时候用的这个指针呢，是木，是竹制的。因为当时的在战时的时候，因为金属匮乏的关系，所以他们开始用其他的素材来做这些唱针。那这些唱针通常也是学生或者是残疾人士在战时的时候经过劳动所贡献出来的。And
there's a map with the location of the place I made the recordings and a phone that's playing fragments of the original record.
在展场里面也看到了，在地图上面会标示出来我当时所录制的地点，还有在透过电话筒的方式，就可以听到这些片段。So
I'd just like to conclude that this piece is about something that happened more than 80 years ago, but I keep finding references in kind of a continuation to today's current situation of this idea of protecting yourself from the airspace. And how civilians have to kind of participate in this is something that I find still relevant and has given me ideas to make further projects in this theme. Thank you.
这些事情虽然发生在80年前、80多年前，可是现在时至今日，其实还是看到这些不同的情况、这些不同的环境之下，我们一定要提到这些防空啊、避难等等这些的概念，依然在现今社会里面扮演不同的角色。所以这也是我这次想要在台湾呈现这些作品的动机跟缘由。谢谢。